53%. Over half of all dogs are considered obese, which is extremely unhealthy, and most of that is driven by what they eat and how much exercise they get. So have you ever wondered the minimum amount that a dog or a puppy needs to exercise each day in order to be healthy? Well, that's what I'm gonna talk about today. I am going to share how much I exercise my dogs, the minimum amount of exercise that I recommend for most dogs and puppies, and then I am going to share my favorite ways to tire dogs out fast. And if there's anything that you do today, watch this video until the very end, because in just a few moments, I'm also going to be sharing with you why all of this is so critically important to your dog. I'm gonna be going into some serious stuff. Hi, Finnegan. Hi, sweet boy. Although he's the sweetest kid ever, my dude here is a high energy dog. And I'm a busy dog mom. I work full time. I make YouTube videos, as you guys obviously can see. And with all of that, I still had to find time to exercise my dogs enough. Suffice it to say, I have found that sweet spot of just enough exercise that I can fit it into my busy schedule and also making sure that my dogs are healthy. The bare minimum of exercise that my dogs need is 15 minutes per day. I have found that sweet spot. If I literally have no time in a day, but I know I want to get them just a minimum amount of exercise that will at least get some of that pent up energy just down a few notches, is 15 minutes. And I don't mean a 15 minute leisurely walk down the sidewalk. I mean, if you're only gonna have time to give them one exercise session a day, then it needs to be a healthy mix of robust physical exertion, like running, getting their heart rate up, mixed with some mental stimulation to tire out both their body and their brain. I'll give you some tips on how to do that at the end, but I have a sneaking suspicion. In fact, I can pretty much guarantee that you're not looking for what the minimum is. You're looking for what's best. So I just talked about the minimum, but what is the optimum? What is the optimal amount of exercise for most dogs or puppies? And what I have learned for my dogs is 30-minute sessions three times a day. Again, that's 30 minutes of robust exercise mixed with physical exertion and mental stimulation. I have had extremely anxious, high energy rescue dogs that I have fostered in my home see great, significant, life-altering improvements by following this balanced structure. These dogs have barked less, stopped chewing on things inappropriately, started behaving better, listening better, and have a more relaxed and calm temperament, which are all huge benefits. And I think most pet parents out there would love to have those results. And in just a moment, I'm going to share the how, meaning how do you actually exercise your dogs during those three 30-minute sessions or during that one 15-minute session. Basically, I'm gonna show you exercises that give you the most bang for your buck. But first, I think it's really important to talk about the why. Why does it matter that you exercise your dog? You already know that a raw, fresh food diet and proper exercise can lead to a healthy weight. You get it. An overweight dog is unhealthy, but there's so much more to it. And this is actually really important and not something people talk about often. Obesity is one of the most common diseases in dogs. Yes, I said the word disease. Being overweight and obese is a disease. And this matters so much because obesity will very likely lead to a number of other diseases and conditions within your dog that can make their life miserable and shorten their life. And that's what none of us want, obviously. Some of the most common diseases and conditions caused by being overweight is diabetes, liver disease, heart disease, high blood pressure, arthritis, think about the extra weight on the joints, digestive issues, behavior problems, even difficulty breathing. This is a serious matter that can't be ignored. And like I mentioned previously, Exercise is really critical in helping your dog maintain a healthy weight. And diet is, of course. If you guys want to know what I recommend in terms of food, types of food, my favorite types of food, click the link up here, or at the end of this video, I have tons of videos linked in the description below, and I talk about the most optimal diet for dogs. And no, because I've actually had several people say this to me, and I just want to nip this in the bud. Having a big fenced backyard is not enough. Dogs are like you and I. They need purpose and intention when it comes to physical activity and mental stimulation. So it's on you to make sure your dog gets enough exercise and a proper diet and live a healthy life. You are their best advocate, and I know you want to do the best for them. So remember that, just putting them outside in a fenced backyard, that is not enough. And so I'm going to talk about in just a second how to exercise them properly. But first, if you're watching this and you're thinking, wow, is my dog obese? Is my dog overweight? I mean, I don't think they are, but if over half of dogs in the US are, maybe mine is. So I'm gonna stick up here on the screen a body condition chart that you can look at with your dog. Of course, you can always ask your holistic or integrative veterinarian to check for you. Before we talk about my favorite, oops, sorry, I didn't mean to block the most important thing in this video, but before we talk about my favorite types of exercises and the best and most efficient ways to exercise your dog, if you're enjoying what you hear so far, if you've learned anything, click that subscribe button. Help us on our mission to save all the damn dogs. So let's talk about the most efficient ways to exercise your dog. I'm just gonna lay down here as I talk about my favorite types of exercises. That's such a juxtaposition if I've ever seen one, but is what it is. I want to chill with my boy and mwah, yes, I do. And here comes Finn. Come on, Finn, come say hi to the camera. Come say hello. All right, guys, so what are your favorite types of exercise? Well, Finn here, my dude. Okay, guys, come over here. Come over here. Finnegan loves fetch, Bentley loves walks. So if you guys want tips on my favorite way to tire these boys out when I only have 15 minutes, as you can tell, they probably need that sooner than later, click the video linked up here or down below. Another unique way to tire your dog out quickly, especially if it's snowing or raining outside or you don't have a backyard, is to find an indoor dog agility center that has basic agility classes or open gym to where you can rent it. Because it's not just about the amount of exercise for your dog, it's the type. So I love finding ways that when I'm doing an exercise session, whether it's a 30-minute session three times a day or a 15-minute session once a day, I like to mix up both physical exertion and mental stimulation. So one thing I love to do is while I'm playing fetch with Finn, for example, if I have a short amount of time to exercise them, I like to throw the ball. And in between each session of throwing the ball, I'll ask him for different commands, whether it be a sit, a down, a stay, a touch. It gets his physical energy out by running after the ball, and it works his mind at the same time between throwing the ball sessions. Also, when I'm walking the boys, I try to maintain about a 12 to 15 minute mile. I have an app that kind of shows me the pace at which I'm walking, but leisurely walks is not going to be enough. It's fine to do leisurely walks, but you have to make sure that you also give your dogs some time to get their energy up. Obviously, going in different terrain, like a hike up and down things, as long as it's not too steep or too rocky, can be really beneficial to tire your dogs out. And then while I'm on walks, I ask them for commands. I may walk for 2 or 3 minutes at a pretty fast pace, and then I'll stop and I'll ask them for sits or downs or touch. Or you could do nose work. I like to hide their meals throughout the house, under boxes, in closets with the door cracked open, and they have to go find their meal. It really stimulates their mind and it helps tire them out. I have a really cool video linked up here that's become really popular on how I use a cardboard box to tire my dogs out. People have been loving it. It's also linked down below. A big caveat to this before I go any further, of course, every dog is different. So you need to be your dog's best advocate on deciding what works for your dog. Your dog may have physical or health limitations. You may have a brachycephalic dog that has some breathing issues. So of course, if you have any concerns, partner with a holistic or integrative veterinarian. These are the things that just work for me. Now, I want you to comment below, how do you exercise your dog today? And what's your biggest hurdle on giving them more exercise? Is it time? Is it the know-how? Is it just that motivation? Comment below and let's encourage each other. Let's help each other in the comments. And you guys already know about my love army, and that's basically you. You going down to the comment section, and when you see people sharing how they exercise their dog, I want you to go congratulate them, because the statistics don't lie. Over half of dogs are overweight, and that means a lot of pet parents aren't exercising their dogs, or they're not exercising them properly. So if you're out there and you're trying your best, then bravo to you. If you need help with getting motivation to exercise your dog, because I know I need that sometimes, comment that below. And then if you see somebody else comment that, go give them a little bit of motivation. Let's lift each other up. And don't forget to connect with me on Instagram. We've almost hit 5,000 supporters there, which is pretty crazy. Just search my name, at Rachel Fasaro. I'm also on Facebook, at Rachel Fasaro. You can find me on my website, rachelfasaro.com. And thank you guys so damn much for being here. You truly make my world spin right. And I hope you have a beautiful day. Goodbye.